What is it? I think part of the appeal of a Toyota Land Cruiser is that you can take it anywhere. I don't mean anywhere as in it can go anywhere, although obviously it can. No, I mean anywhere as in, to the shops, to a client meeting, to a shoot or building site or the theater or a pony club rally, where at any of the above a Land Cruiser would say precisely the same thing about you, next to nothing. Toyota's biggest, baddest and most luxurious and expensive off-roader, for the UK, at least, is, then, the most curious of things, the classless car, capable of doing everything, but shouting out while it does it, except that you bought it because you need it. Anyway, now, this car, which was introduced in this form in 2009, and which has had a couple of minor changes since, has for 2018 been rather more heavily revised to try and keep pace with its rivals, nearly all of which have been entirely replaced, platform and all. Since then, the Land Rover Discovery, the key rival even away from a JLR centric UK market, the Nissan Patrol, absent from the UK, Jeep Grand Cherokee, plus other luxury-focused SUVs like the Volvo XC90, BMWs, Audis, Mercedes and, well, everyone who offers a big 4x4, which is pretty much everyone. But notwithstanding all of their rivals, the basics of the Land Cruiser are what they still were. It has a body-on-frame construction, albeit 11% more torsionally rigid than it was, with a few minor tweaks the outside, to aid cooling, and higher wings to help you place the edges of the car. There are 3 drams and 5 drams body styles, with 5 or 7 seats, all of which can be had in the UK in trim levels stretching up to Invincible, which costs £52,295 as a 5 drams, which is how they're mostly bought in Britain. In an effort to get as much value as it can from the model, though, and perhaps spotting that the Land Rover Defender is no longer available, for now, at least, Toyota is now introducing a more basic, workhorsey variant, too. The utility version can be had from £32,795 as a 3-door manual. Whisper has it that the body on frame's versatility, from a mini body style's perspective, hasn't gone entirely unnoticed at Toyota either. Power comes from a 2.8-liter diesel engine, in Britain that's all we get, other markets can have bigger petrols and so on, tweaked by a new, smaller, turbo, and urea exhaust solution combo, and it makes a steady 174 bhp, driving all 4 wheels through either a 6-speed manual or auto gearbox.